evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Patti LuPone, and I will be your hostess this evening. I think I'd like to introduce you to my co-host, Mr. John McDanile. We are both very happy and very excited that the Nantucket AIDS Network invited us to perform for you tonight. It's a very beautiful island, and for those of you that live here, you're extremely lucky. This is my third visit, John's first. Every time I come here, I sort of feel like a stranger in the past.
Flowering in a heart of a tree. A wandering star in the west, or a heartbreak call from a meadow lark's nest, made me think for a moment maybe it's true. I've found you in the storm, in the calm, in the blue, but it never was you. It never was anywhere you.
3 years ago, I gave birth to a baby boy. These next two songs are dedicated to him.
Maybe.
too.
Johnny. Thank you.
obviously the beginning of the theater section. That was Don't Cry For Me, Argentina, from Evita. I played Evita. My musical career actually started 3 years earlier in a musical called The Baker's Wife. There's a theatrical joke that goes, if Hitler were alive today, his punishment should be to send him out on the road with a musical in trouble. We were that musical. We were on the road for 6 months. That was the out-of-town tryout. And it was written by Stephen Schwartz. It was based on a very famous French film called La Femme de Boulanger. And it was written by Stephen Schwartz, and it was produced by Schwartz / Motown and the great impresario David Merrick. David Merrick hated the next song I'm about to sing for you and was overheard in a bar in Boston saying, I'll get that song out if I have to poison the bird seed. He went into the orchestra pit the next day before a matinee and took all the charts off of the stands in the orchestra pit, locked them in his attaché case, and went back to New York. That's the first time the song was out. I remember we were on the road for 6 months. The song was out, the song was in, the song was out, the song was in, the song was out, the song was out, the song was in, the song was out. Out in. In Washington, D.C., where we set a house record at the Kennedy Center for the least attended show in Kennedy Center history, we had 25 people in a 2,700-seat house. That's actually where we closed in Washington. We closed 2 days shy of our New York opening. And the names were up on the marquee. It was an amazing, it was horrible experience. Anyway, my part was reduced to making an entrance, hello, Margaret, making an exit, goodbye, Margaret, to making an entrance at the end of the show, hello, Margaret. The musical was The Baker's Wife. The song was, the role was Genevieve, and the song was Meadowlark. She was blind, the lark was blind. 1976 and 1977. I don't know why.
I didn't know the show was Stephen Schwartz.
This was as bad as the other one. Not the show. Just, you know, sometimes it's not, sometimes music, I can't even talk. Never mind. Some of you know out there. And it just there's a fine line between success and failure, and that especially applies to the Broadway musical or any musical. It just, something tips the balance, and it's a success or it's a flop. Anyway, this next one was a flop. However, in this next one, Working, I didn't have a song, so let's just skip right on past Working. That was 77, and then when I was 79, I did Ibiza. Then in 1984, I think it was, I did this next show. I don't know when it started, but I started stealing costumes from every show I was in. On this particular show, I stole the shoes, the stockings, the garters that held up the stockings, the pantaloons, the chemise, the shawl, and the wig. The only thing I left in my dressing room on closing night was the dress. A few years later, I had to sing this particular role for the Queen of England at the Royal Variety performance, and it's a good thing I stole all that, because the only thing they had was the dress. Then I left the dress. The show was Oliver, the role was Nancy, the song is As Long As He Needs Me.
Thank you.
1985, I was asked to be a member of the Royal Shakespeare Company's world premiere production of Les Miserables in London, and I, of course, said yes. I went to London, and I rehearsed in the Royal Shakespeare Company's London Hall, the Barbican Theatre, and I felt as though I had come full circle. It felt like the school I attended to become an actor. I was very proud to be a member of the Royal Shakespeare Company. And the production was extraordinary. In my eyes, in this naive American's eyes, I was in this experience. And 2 weeks after we opened at the Barbican, I knew that I would not be able to take the show to Broadway. And I told the producer that, Cameron McIntosh, and he said, well, of course, I understand, Patti. I felt the role was too small. And it was not about that. It was about the perfect theatrical experience. It's something we all hope for in our lives, not the perfect theatrical experience, but a perfect experience. And certainly in theater, it's very rare. And to me, this was. It was the perfect cast and the perfect play in a perfect environment. And I wanted to leave it that way. The only thing a stage actor has is the memory of the experience. It's the only thing you have of the theatrical experience, is the memory of it. It's not immortalized. You can't play it back and see it over and over again. So I chose to leave my performance and that production in London. The role was Fantine. The song is I Dreamed a Dream.
There was a time when love was blind.
recently, besides being the most the perfect theatrical experience, I never would have done two musicals back to back. And had I done one of those in New York, I never would have done this next show. And it was the first time since the show I neglected to mention, The Rubber Bridegroom. It was the first time since The Rubber Bridegroom in 1976 that I was in a true musical comedy. And they just don't write them like that anymore. They don't write like Cole Porter wrote. The feeling was so thrilling to look out at the audience, and I could because it was a thrust stage at Lincoln Center's Vivian Beaumont Theater, and see the audience crying with joy and laughing. There's nothing more thrilling. The show was Anything Goes, the song is Anything Goes, but no singing. I'm Peter B. Mumford, Sam Skipper, and Ed Sunley. You don't know these names. They weren't famous. Ed Sunley was the men's costumer for a television show I did before he died of AIDS. Sam and Peter were production stage managers on various shows that I did. They too died of AIDS. They were known in theatrical terms as crew, and they were as integral a part of entertainment as any performer. And you never saw them. All the Eds, Peters, and Sams, because, well, they were backstage or behind a camera. But they were there. They were my colleagues. They were my friends.
told you about that show that I skipped right over. It was in 1976. It was actually 1975, the John Hammond Acting Company, into 1976. The show with them. I do remember the lyrics. I might not. Anyway, the show was the Robert Bright and the role was Rosalind and the song is Sleepy Man. Well, they go to the other one.
And I need you to stay.
fortune.